remember, you didn't have to come over and make breakfast for me.
No problem. I didn't get to see you last night, so I wanted to get an early start today.
Uh-oh. When a woman comes over before noon, it means trouble. That's sweet.
No, you're sweet.
But as long as the togetherness ends here, I'm cool.
Hey, as long as I'm here, we should drive into work together.
Red alert! Red alert!
Oh, Amber, what brings you by so early? I wanted to see Marion and fix a little breakfast. Oh, isn't that romantic? Isn't that romantic, Marion?
Isn't it time you get out of my house, Tiffany?
Yes, it's very romantic.
All right, I'll see you two later. I'm late. So, did you know that today is our 1 month anniversary?
Of course I did. She's counting days? That's bad. But at least she's not buying me a gift.
I got your present. It's a key to my condo.
Wow, thanks, baby. Okay, don't panic, Marion. It's just an offer. You don't have to use it.
You can have a copy of yours made for me later.
Be cool. This is just a phase. It's all over. It can't get any worse than this.
You know, Marion, I love you.
Down, 13, 14, 36, 24, 36.
Come on, coach, you're not paying attention to your form.
You pay attention to my form, I pay attention to her form.
Gentlemen, I've finally come up with a way to put our competition out of business.
You gonna go work for him?
I've hired a skywriter. I'm tired of that clinic across the street always one-upping us, taking all of our business. But wait till they see our name in 50-foot puffs across the sky. God, I'm good.
Let me know how it turns out. Come on, coach. Let's work on your arms.
Yeah.
What's the matter with you?
My relationship with Amber hit a major snag.
She yelled out my name?
Not even in your dreams, Max.
So what happened?
She told me she loved me.
Oh, that's man, I'm sorry to hear that, man. Oh, now, wait a minute. It may not be as bad as it looks. Did she say, I love you or love you, babe?
She said, I love you.
Yeah. Been nice knowing you, son.
Well, what'd you say back to her?
I said what any man in my position would say. Is that my beeper?
And you know, that's good. Man, if they'd had beepers 30 years ago, I'd still own a house.
This morning, Amber told Marion that she loved him.
Oh, that's wonderful!
Classic mistake. I knew that poor fool was gonna slip up sooner or later. Strap a rocket to her butt and point her north, because she is out of here!
No, because Marion told her he loved her back, didn't you, Marion?
Is that my beep?
You didn't tell her? You wimp.
Hey, now, wait a minute, Tiff. You know, it's not that easy for a man to say to a woman, I love you. Matter of fact, I didn't say it to my ex-wife until after she bought me a winning lottery ticket.
Well, let's face the possibility here. Maybe Marion doesn't love her.
Yeah. I wouldn't say all that.
Well, let's just see what Mr. Webster has to say. Love, love. Oh, here it is. Do you feel strong affection?
Yeah.
Big deal. You feel that about your stereo.
Do you feel warm all over?
Very warm.
Shoot, you could wet your pants and feel that.
Do you enjoy her greatly?
Extremely greatly, especially lately.
Well, then, according to Mr. Webster, Marion, you...
Really gotta return this call.
Marion, no matter what you're feeling, you're gonna have to tell her.
Until then, that I love you is just gonna be hanging over your head.
Like a big old rickety chandelier.
Tonia.
Hey, Gary.
Can I interest you in ordering a case of our new 2-liter sports bottles?
Let me think. Sure.
Can I interest you in some dinner and a movie?
Let me think. No.
Good news, Tonia. I got our skywriting ad down to 11 letters. I didn't mention you or Marion.
That's not bad, Doc. Of course, the clinic across the street did theirs in 10.
What?
Yeah, I saw it on the way in. Go see for yourself.
I can't believe that. They went and hired a skywriter?
Well, that's the third time they've beat us to the punch with their own ideas. Something's up.
And I know exactly what it is. They got a psychic over there. Be quiet. Let me see if I can hear what she's thinking.
That's not it. I think there's a spy in our midst.
You're right. That's probably why I can't get a reading.
Or that unstable connection in your head. What kind of scum-sucking vermin would stoop that low?
Hello.
Of course. Bernie the chiropractor's the mole.
Look, if we're gonna start tossing around physical insults, you're not so unrodent-like yourself.
Oh, come on, Bert, admit it. You've been stealing all my ideas and selling it to that clinic across the street.
Oh, yeah, I'm making a fortune selling the secrets that have made this place such a financial powerhouse.
There's gotta be somebody. Somebody with access to both clinics. Someone we trust. Somebody who knows what goes on in here.
Hey, guys. Hey, Tonia.
Don't even think about it.
Wait a minute. He delivers the mail. He goes right from here to there every day, and you tell him everything.
Max Henry is not the one.
I missed you last night.
Mm-mm. I missed you more.
No, you didn't.
Yes, I did.
Yes, I did.
Yeah, well, even if he isn't the spy, I still may have to execute him.
So that's the guy that Tonya goes for instead of me, huh? Well, maybe I'll have to come down here in my tight shorts.
Can you give us 24 hours notice? Hidden microphone in clock. Clock in box. Box delivered to competition. Max catches spy. Damn, I'm good. Do I read me? Yes, I read me. They say that cat Max is a bad mother. Shut your mouth.
But I'm talking about Max. You heard me, dear.
Double did not.
Triple did.
Hey, Henry, would you deliver this box over to the clinic across the street as a little gift for the grand opening?
Oh, you got it, Doc.
Well, I'm gonna go back into my office and work on my next great idea for our clinic. Of course, I've lost the keys to my door, so it'll be unlocked. Hope no one looks in my upper right-hand drawer tonight.
Max, did you put a microphone in this box? Look, I don't know what you're up to, but leave Henry out of this. He is not your spy.
Blinded by love, the poor, berated fool.
I'll see you tonight.
I believe in you.
Hey, Henry, you almost forgot my package.
Oh, yeah, thanks, Doc. You know, you're always looking out for me.
Looking, listening, I'm doing it all.
One thing I know is I care for Amber. No, and that's what I'm gonna tell her when I see her tonight. Amber, I care for you. That doesn't sound lame, does it?
Lame? If it was a horse, it'd be glue.
Hi, Marion.
Hey. I gotta go see a man about a horse.
Listen, Amber, there was something I had to tell you.
No, wait. Me first. I have some exciting news. Well, it's bad news, but it's also exciting.
Exciting bad news? You got courtside seats to a Clippers game?
I got a promotion.
That's good.
It's in Tokyo.
That's good. I mean, that's bad.
Well, the Tokyo office is in trouble, and headquarters wants me to go there and run things for a while. It could be a long while.
You're leaving?
In a couple of days.
Congratulations. I'm proud of you.
Well, I got a million things to do. Can what you have to tell me wait until tonight?
Oh, tonight, tomorrow, turn of the century.
I'll see you tonight around 8. Mm-hmm. Your place.
Welcome. congratulations, Marion. Once again, you have dodged the love bullet.
What's going on?
Oh, Amber's leaving town in a couple of days. Looks like Marion is off the hook.
Whoa, my friend. Way to use that get-out-of-commitment-free card.
Actually, now that I know she's leaving, I feel like it'd be easier to tell her how I feel.
And I know just how to do it. You can shout it to the jet as it's leaving the ground.
In the park, strolling the summer days of imagining
in my head. This is beautiful, Marion.
I wanted our last night to be special. What time do you want me to take you to the airport tomorrow?
I don't. I hired a car. I don't like goodbyes.
Okay, this is gonna be easy.
Are you gonna miss me?
More than you know.
Boy, he's taking it hard. Well, I wish I wasn't going.
Me too.
I mean, who knows what would have happened if I stayed.
That rickety chandelier would flatten my head. Okay, say something nice. I guess we'd be doing some serious talking about our future.
Our future? He's getting plural.
You mean our future together?
You can't just sit here with a stupid smile on your face. You gotta say something. Quick, anything. Of course I mean our future together.
Oh, Marion. If that's what you want, I'll be with you forever.
You accidentally proposed. That's like accidentally painting your house or accidentally eating a bucket of nails.
You don't drink. You're not insane. Her daddy wasn't standing over you with a shotgun. How did this happen?
All I know is one minute we were kissing, she was leaving, I was missing her, and somehow the word future slipped out.
Oh, Marion, there's certain words you never use in front of a woman, like future and credit cards and water weight.
Wait. Maybe it's not as bad as it sounds. Now, did you say the future or your future?
I think it was our future.
Oh, no!
What happened now?
Marion's engaged.
Marion, congratulations. This is for your own good. Everybody, back away from the door. Marion, I'm taking you to South America. We're going to stop by the house first and get a passport and your favorite hat.
The only place I'm going is to clear things up with Amber.
And now, wait a minute. You were going to clear up I love you, and you came back engaged. Now, what's going to happen when you clear up engaged?
He'll wind up with a baby on board sign in his Jeep.
Max! Max! What are you doing, double O, stupid?
I'm about to get enough dirt on your boyfriend and nail him to the wall.
You gave Henry that package even though I told you not to?
Poor, sweet, dumb Tonya. Too close to see the truth.
Poor, sweet, dumb Max. Just close enough for me to smack the snot out of him. Henry is not the spy. I know him.
Spoke like a true prison bride. I tell you what. I'll turn on the speakers and hear the truth, and you can go stand by your man somewhere else.
I have complete faith in my Henry, and there's nothing you can do or say that's going to change that. Just shut up.
More information tonight. We'll drive that idiot Stanton into the ground. Hey, you sure got that Tonya chick wrapped around your finger?
Oh, I'm devastated.
Hey, how do you think I feel? Every ham radio geek in the state thinks I'm an idiot.
You're here! Come on in. Go.
Have them send the contracts here. Thanks.
What's all this?
Time management. I'm on a jet in 24 hours. If we're going to get married, we need to make some decisions. Now, I had Donna go out and pick up some samples of some things we might want to register for.
I planned my sister's wedding. Not that anyone got to see my vision. Her jerk fiancé got cold feet and left the week before.
Donna.
I'm sorry, Marion. Gutless men who break engagement certainly have...